An 11,500-year-old infant has been unearthed in Alaska, and Sunrise Girl Child's DNA suggests that rather than several migratory waves over time, all Native American ancestry traces back to one massive migration. And to breed plants that use water more efficiently, researchers at Iowa State University are measuring exactly how long it takes for corn plants to move water from their roots to their leaves, using graphene plant tattoos. Vsauce! Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. The world's first photovoltaic expressway has debuted in China. Keilu Transportation Development Group has built a 1 kilometer stretch of road that has a bottom layer of insulation, a middle layer of solar-powered batteries, and a top layer of transparent concrete. The electricity will power highway lights, cameras, and signs, but the developers are hoping that it will power electric cars and melt snow in the future. But the cost is high. It's $458 per square meter compared to $5 for a standard asphalt road. And the 1 kilometer stretch will only create enough electricity to power 93 homes for 1 year. So this has a long way to go before it becomes like a thing. Shrimp claws took 150 million years to develop. A study of 114 species of shrimp has revealed how they're able to snap their claws. Researchers at the University of Alberta found what they call extreme biology. Shrimp evolving to make use of an air vacuum that stores and expends energy in a snap. Shrimp use the snapping motion to communicate, attack prey, and defend themselves. So that 150 million years was totally worth it. And shrimp are delicious. Millions of diabetics could benefit from a skin-like surface. Currently, diabetics have to prick their skin to monitor blood sugar levels. Not only is it painful, but it can result in infections and other complications. But researchers in Beijing have found that ultra-thin, skin-like biosensors can reliably monitor glucose levels in a non-invasive way, which means more comfort and better monitoring. 20 years ago, a popo started training hero rats to detect landmines and diagnose tuberculosis, and they're getting more efficient. It takes 4 days for a lab technician to evaluate 100 samples of sputum, or for a minesweeper to cover an area the size of a tennis court. A hero rat can do either job in just 30 minutes. Research and development includes teaching rats to indicate the presence of mines by flipping a collar switch and identifying the presence of new diseases. So, thanks, rats. We tend to think of robots as rigid metal creations. For now. The Keplinger Research Group at the University of Colorado is developing soft robots that mirror the makeup and movements of biological muscle tissue. Soft robotics allows machines to be as forceful or gentle as they need to be, and researchers say the muscle-like electrical actuators that make industrial and commercial applications possible can be produced now for about 10 cents. Humanity has milked its first platypus. The male platypus has a venomous spur on its hind feet that it uses to compete with other males for mates. But until now, no one has extracted the venom. Tim Faulkner of the Australian Reptile Park successfully took a sample of venom, which includes a hormone that may be useful in treating diabetics. The world's first DJ robot is spinning in the Czech Republic. A club in Prague challenged robotics manufacturer KUKA to make a robotic arm that controls the action and can respond to the crowd. And the challenge was accepted. But the robot music revolution isn't happening quite yet. The club is alternating between human and robot DJs every hour. Do tiny sea turtles that hatch on the beach get tired when they don't make it to the water quickly enough? Researchers at Florida Atlantic University put them on a treadmill to find out. Sea turtles crawl toward the light, which means urban glows can disorient them. FAU researchers found that the turtles crawl, rest, and keep crawling even after hours of effort. They're little crawling machines, and as a wise zombie child once said, "I like turtles." At Columbia University's Robotics and Rehabilitation Lab, exoskeletons are helping train people to walk again.
The goal is to be able to build and design lightweight wearable exoskeletons, an exoskeleton that doesn't have explicit joints that can either assist them in their movement or train them so that they could eventually walk without these exoskeletons.
To come up with novel inventions in science and technology, we need to develop our own toolkits and frameworks for understanding. instead of just blindly memorizing formulas. Brilliant's interactive problems are a great way for you to really understand math and science. They have everything from number theory to mastering casino blackjack, or this one I really like that explains solar energy from the ground up. We all know that solar panels absorb the sun's energy, but what is it that they actually do? So click the link at the top of this video's description to get 20% off your annual subscription. Your brain will thank you. Now I'm going to leave you with an Animal robot that greets a new friend in an interesting way. You'll see. And as always, thanks for watching.
Small calculator, a really silent electronic, a really fast thinker, one that works anywhere on battery or plug-in, one with all the calculator know-how you'll probably ever need. Introducing the world's smallest electronic calculator from the maker of the world's most complete line, Sharp. Introducing the LC8, world's smallest electronic calculator by Sharp. Price tag to match, $345 complete. LC8, the answer.